yes, there may be perceived rules, but we should ignore them. And the reason I think about that so strongly is from a technical development side, yes, we can say there are more men probably in those fields today, have grew up with computer science degrees and took those forward. Yet, where Blue Prism really focuses our solution and the business-led benefits of our solution is in the operational side of the business. And who typically sits in the operational side of the business? It's women. And it's because they are very process-oriented and they really take into consideration the elements of the human workforce and how the digital workforce can sit side by side and improve the outcomes for that business. I think a lot of women can be role models, not only for their daughters, for their sons, who need to respect women in the workforce, and also for people within their communities. I really thought about when my daughters got to the age of university, what types of schools should they go to? I had them go to what's called co-op schools, and co-op schools are schools that have specific programs for people to not only learn in the typical educational process, but they go into real work environments. They have to interview, they have to understand how to show their strengths in a world that is made up still, as we all know, of a majority of men. So they learn very early on how to jump over those barriers, how to show their differentiated value to the market, and how to get that confidence. Because really, it's all about confidence. Whether you're a man or a woman in business, it doesn't matter. But everything you're doing is selling, right? You could be selling a story inside the business to get funding. You could be selling to an end customer. You could be selling, in my case, to partners that you want to take your product into the market. So building your confidence early on in life, whether it be through programs like Girl Scouts, different types of programs where girls can really get involved in different types of programs that let them stand out, project who they are as a person, and then take that all the way through their life. Get your experience early, have the confidence to succeed. There's one lady in my life I want to talk about. She was a role model for me right after I had my second child. And I was probably 35 years old at the time. And right at that point in my life where I could have stayed in more of a first level management type position, or I could have rose to the higher level positions. And she took me aside, and as a very interesting story, you know, she hired for me a consultant that took me into Saks Fifth Avenue in New York and bought me a whole new wardrobe of clothes. And I know that sounds kind of funny, but at that point in your career, you have to become somebody different, right? You have to look at who you're going to be, not who you are today, because that's the image you need to project. So projecting the image of who I was going to be was what she really helped me do. I will always be thankful for her to doing that. The first key characteristic is a love of mentoring. People see in themselves who they are today. They also see a little bit of who they wish they were. And the wish they were piece is a mentoring behavior that people will then bring to the next generation of people that they see that they can help get to not only where they are, but to that next level. So they look for characters of strength. They look for people that have insight and people that aren't afraid to try new things. And then they mentor them to be somebody that they can be. Again, and I did a lot of training when I was younger, and the first thing they always told you was, imagine the future, become that person. Leadership is second, right? If you don't have strong leadership skills in business, you will not be successful. So people that have really strong leadership skills, and again, want to impart them on other people that they can help succeed. And then people with networks. And if there's one thing I say to younger women that I know is, you know, stop using email, stop using text, have conversations with people, get to know them, network with them. Those networks will carry you through your life. RPA is letting, we call them, at Blue Prism, we call them digital entrepreneurs, right? They're people that are within the organization that wouldn't necessarily rise to the top. They're not going to be the next CFO or CIO. They're not those roles today. They're people that really understand how the business works and have the insight to determine how that business could be better and have the risk-taking desire to really take on something new and different to to drive those business outcomes. If you listen to the people that are on stage at Blue Prism World this week and others that I have heard, they're people that you would say, hey, that's kind of just an everyday person in the business. And when you see that, you go, wow, I don't have to be the CEO. I don't have to be the CFO. I can be the person that knows what I do better than anybody else. And I can now understand how to improve that, take the elements of RPA, what we call our Center of Excellence capabilities, and apply them using the robotic operating model to really drive change for the business. And they rise up, these digital entrepreneurs, they rise up as superstars in their business. It's got to be all of the elements across the organization understanding that the more diverse our organization is, whether it's women, whether it's people from different cultures, whether it's, you know, men, it doesn't really matter where it is. It's important for each of us to bring our strengths, to respect what each other brings to the table, and never feel afraid to take a risk. My most risky assignment I ever took was moving my family from the US into Japan. I was 35 years old, young woman, and taking on a pretty big role in Japan. Didn't understand the language, couldn't speak, but it was the best experience I ever had in my life. It was very good for me. It was very good for my family, for those two young daughters growing up, to be able to have a very international, a cultural experience, young in life. It has done a world of good for them as they've now proceeded through their career. So take risk is my big message to those women out there that really want to show who they can be.